Hello and welcome. I'm David Robinson, the online editor at The Banker, and today we're going to look at decentralized finance, or DeFi, and how it could potentially shake up the banking system in the decades to come. It's the cover story of the September issue of The Banker. With me to discuss this is James King, the Europe editor of The Banker. James, let's start with the basics. What is DeFi?
So DeFi is a parallel financial system, which is totally separate from the traditional financial system that we know, banks, capital markets, central banks, and so on. And DeFi basically exists in the digital realm. So it sits on blockchains, it's fully decentralized, a peer-to-peer financial system. Blockchains is the underlying architecture, and cryptocurrencies or stable coins as sort of the monetary value which runs through the system. And that's basically what it is. But it's certainly a parallel system and a new way of thinking about finance.
Why do you feel at this juncture it's really starting to matter?
I think it's just because it's a question of one is sort of value. And if you look at sort of total locked value in DeFi today, which measures all of the sort of, you know, in US dollars, all of the investments put into the DeFi space, it's about 80 billion. It's even been close to 90 billion at some point. And that growth has really come from almost nothing. It was about $600 million back in sort of January 2020. So to get to 80 billion today, it's a huge growth story. And it matters because, you know, DeFi really does sort of rethink the way financial services are conducted, the way they're executed. And it's probably going to lead to a lot of change, a lot of evolution for the traditional financial space as well.
Yeah, I suppose this leads into my next question, James, which is what are the implications of DeFi for the future of finance?
Yeah, well, it's a great question, and it's really it's a difficult one to answer in some ways because there's a lot of dimensions to this. I mean, if you are a DeFi or a cryptocurrency critic, you know, the whole thing is, you know, sort of a Ponzi scheme and it's going to blow up before too long. But if you look at this and you believe in what you see and you think it's a compelling idea or theme which sort of, you know, sits behind DeFi, then it will reshape the future of financial services, because basically what it does is it makes everyone their own bank. You put up your own balance sheet, you have your own wallet, there are no sort of intermediary systems there, and it gives you full autonomy over the way that you use and allocate your capital. So it does just put the user or the individual first. Beyond that, there's no kind of monetization of user data, for example. This is all about sovereignty of the self. So these ideas are quite compelling, and they're probably going to change the way we think, not only about finance, but about the broader world around us.
No, James, thank you. I imagine the impact of decentralized finance is just going to grow and change and impact everything. And it's something obviously we'll continue to follow closely on The Banker.